welcome back to the university. Yes. So in this video, I'm going to teach you how to create postcards from a database using Envisioned. So before anything else, please click the subscribe button right here and click the notification bell. Ding, ding, ding. Get updated whenever I post the university posts and videos like this. So let's go ahead and visit my PhD, my admin. As you can see, it's an event and there's a lot of data in there, which are the data of hours. Right, so what we want is to make use of this data to create cards. Right, so go ahead and check our visual studio code. Is the visual studio code. I just removed the code from this one, okay, because for demonstration purposes. So I need to say I have no code like this one, but the codes are working. They work using this visual studio code. Okay. So we have 8. So just keep it as it is, right? As plain as it is. So inside this particular document, okay, we will create the trigger. Okay, so the trigger is the form, right? So you write form, and the method is post, okay, and we let the action to be blank, right? So let's do that. So because we want to submit the trigger inside this box, okay? So then we have the input, okay? Yeah. So submit button. So you can choose where to submit here again. There, and then next is to create a name. Okay, so name is equal to like this, and name is submit. All right, there we go. So that's the first portion. Next portion is to check whether the submission is working like that. So we're gonna write the code here. Ethan. Submit. Yeah, so this one. Yeah, that one, and inside is the code to be executed if submit is being clicked. So let's say echo is to print out this word. Say hello word. Perfect. So Alyssa, but later on we're going to change that into functional code. So let's make it as simple as this one and check whether we have the working button. Alright, so we go back to the website. Basically, you are going to use MySQL and a mixture of PHP and MySQL so that you're able to execute things properly. Okay? Them from being executed on the same line. All right, so let's go back to the website or on the localhost rather. So and then hit refresh, right? And you will see that there's only one button again, and it should just be called hello world here. The maximum number in the table items. Alright, so let's get a cards. Alright, so there we go. We use the hello world for our entries inside this. Alright, so check. You can check later. Alright. So right now we are supposed to in our tool. And then next thing is to well, there are several entries. Right, several different entries. We want to make for each then, all right, so the name of the folder must also contain the name of the student, which is variable here, which is the folder. So if we were able to echo that variable right here earlier, we will be able to use that data, take that information and pass it here and make it append or make it as our name of the folder. So right now I'm gonna show you the current working directory, which is there it is. So those are the folders that is going to be placed in the files. So you see that then we have the dashboard and then image.php, but I don't have this directory that name either. Right, so meaning to say it's gonna make folder inside the htdocs named ecards, right? And inside the ecards there will be another folder which is named after the name of the student. So let's try to run this code. Need to say we have to go back to the localhost and click refresh. There we go, and once I hit the refresh button, click this one, right? Right, so there we go. I see some error, so it hurts to click one on to make their permission. Phrase or string is also a dot. Okay, so that means the code becomes invalid. Alright, so let's see another instance wherein the student have the dot again, and since it's not executable, so there is an error. Containing many subfolders are able to hit. Right, so there we go. So here I'm gonna merge the view. The last one. erase it, because if we I think it's execute it again. It will yield to an error because the directory is already there. Okay, so should remove it. Okay, so all right. So we go back to our visual code and start moving again. Yeah, there we go. So we were able to get everything. Okay, and we are able to get the directory. So we have to make the directory, so we are coding for flight. There's no red red sign. One is done. Okay. So what are these tools? Okay. If you are learning, guys, and if you like videos like this, please subscribe button and hit the notification bell. Get updated whenever we post new videos. As I told you, the university is right now, you have to HTML things, okay, HTML elements into Excel. Right. So how do you do that? Actually, how do you get the HTML, the exact HTML code of your Excel? Right. So you go ahead and export. Right. So your Excel to web page. Okay. Like your HTML, you're gonna get this. And well, the new document. There we go. So the phone has been dead. But you will see that I thought you're gonna make it fine, but it's not like a car. So right. We make it apart by typing localhost on the address bar. Yeah, and once I hit this, there will be a download. Okay, named chilipack.com. So there's a download. Right now, and to show you that it worked. All right.